others have turned this into a very automated process where you can put in saliva, get out DNA.
Joe Pickerel is a geneticist and CEO at GenCove, a company that makes genomic data accessible and interpretable.
Most of the tests that you're familiar with and that we've used are based around a technology called genotyping. What our technology is based around is increasing that by orders of magnitude. Instead of looking at 100,000 sites, you would look at 10 million or 100 million sites. And in the long run, this is the type of data that will make these tests much more powerful.
The genetic genealogy market is currently dominated by Ancestry.com and 23andMe, which use genotyping to give consumers information based on their DNA. I ordered a test through Ancestry.com and was surprised that the test actually worked when I was matched to relatives I hadn't known taking the test. So how do these companies extract your DNA from the saliva you ship off to a lab?
So in your saliva are there cells. Most of them, it's kind of interesting, half of them, probably about half of the cells are, you know, white blood cells. There's sort of blood cells that you spit out. The other half is your sort of skin cells. And each of those cells is your genome. And the genome is about the same in every cell in your body. It's 3.3 billion chemical bases all strung together. And in those 3.3 billion, there are many that are different among people. So you might have a particular genetic variant that I don't have. But the genetic variant that you have is definitely shared with one of your parents, and is definitely shared with one of your grandparents, and so on.
Surprisingly, the popularity behind DNA kits is nothing new.
Well, it turns out genealogy has been a hobby for people for hundreds and hundreds of years. It was probably the biggest hobby in the 1800s among, you know, certain classes of people. And now that's just, now we have sort of a modern day equivalent of that. A lot of them, it's more of a focus on either an ancestry, genealogy, pure genealogy product, which would be your MyHeritage or Ancestry DNA. There are tests like 23andMe that also have a more medical angle.
For example, my health results from 23andMe showed that I have a slight risk for macular degeneration, but no variant for late-onset Alzheimer's. Meanwhile, my DNA results were very similar to my Ancestry.com ones.
Although it seems like fun to order a DNA test kit without a second thought, these kits can stir up issues about privacy, as well as open up a Pandora's box of family secrets.
Anonymity is gone. That's the short answer. And there's no such thing as anonymous sperm donation anymore. There's basically no such thing as anonymous adoptees anymore.
And at the end of the day, who owns that DNA data?
I think all of the companies would say that you own it, and you've given them a lot of rights to it. My understanding is you can take those rights away if you choose to. You could take your data and delete your account and tell them to delete everything.
So whether you want to simply find out your ancestry or delve into your medical probabilities, think twice before you purchase a DNA test, because your privacy may be at risk while the industry will continue to boom. I'm Tinabeth Pina for Simply Science.